Good, thank you. So any questions you have from the previous material? Hokies had a nice evening yesterday, so they won the game. I think my information is correct. So what we were doing was balance of energy. So let's do that now in the reference configuration. So it's balance of energy. Also called first law of thermodynamics. So we did that yesterday, like yesterday afternoon, in the present configuration. So we have this piece P, and we look at the region or in the reference configuration from which this piece came. So now we are going to write things in the reference configuration. So that's the only difference between what we did last night or last evening and what we are going to do now. So the rate of change of energy, which is of two parts, and this measured per unit mass, and we are going to write per mass element as rho zero times dV. This is capital volume. This is d, not velocity. So if you like, I can use omega, or I can leave it as V. This is not velocity. This is volume in the reference configuration. So this is the mass element, and energy has two parts: internal energy, which is per unit mass, plus kinetic energy. So that's 1/2 mv square. M is outside, so this is v square, is vx square plus vy square plus vz square, and this is integrated over the wall shape R. So this should equal the work done by present forces acting both inside the body and on the surface of the body. So inside is body force, so that's rho zero B I V I dV. So to keep the distinction between velocity and volume, velocity has an index I on it, because velocity is a vector. Volume is a scalar. So wherever you see VI, that's velocity. And again, this is on the integration is over R, plus the work done by surface forces, and the surface force is now TILNL. That's the force per unit undeformed area, but it is acting on the present shape. It's the present force per unit undeformed area. And T here, T tilde, is the first Piola-Kirchhoff stress tensor. Capital N is the normal, unit outward normal, at a point in the reference configuration. And if we dot it with the present velocity, so we will get the work done by external forces. So this is the work done by contact forces. But these contact forces are being measured per unit area in the reference configuration. Plus heat. Now the heat flux are these heat energy, thermal energy. So the radiation term is rho zero R dV, that's per unit mass. So R is the energy received from the sun, R from bodies not touching the one we are studying. So this R is the energy, rate of energy received per unit mass from everything in the universe, except the ones which are touching it. So this is this body, this part is receiving energy from every other body that is not touching it, and that we are denoting as R per unit mass. A typical example is sun. If you are sitting in the sun, like today is a nice day, it's a sunny day, and our friend is still cold, even though he's inside the room. But when you walk outside this in the sun, you won't need to put your cap on because it is warm outside. So you are receiving energy from the sun. Whether you like it or not, you don't have a choice. So you receive it. So you receive energy from, in principle, you are receiving, we are exchanging energy too, even though we are not touching each other. Yeah. But the rate of energy received may be minuscule. It is probably negligible as compared to the one you will receive from the sun if you are sitting in the sun. So that is R. R is the rate of energy received per unit mass. So this basically says if a person weighs more, has more mass, then the person will receive more energy from the sun. Which may or may not be true, but that's the assumption we are making. So R is the rate of energy received per unit mass. Also, if you are touching something, typically hot pan, if you are cooking, then you also receive energy through the surface. And that energy through the surface, we are going to indicate by QLDA, and N is the outward unit normal. So this is the energy received. Q is the rate of energy received per unit surface area. This QLNL is the energy received per unit surface area. And this is called heat flux. But this is no heat flux per unit area in the reference configuration. So last night we introduced something, we said it's per unit area in the present configuration. Now we are saying it's per unit area in the reference configuration. The amount of energy received must be same. Okay, otherwise the things won't balance out. So what we are saying is, and that's what we did about the forces too, that if you integrate QL NL DA over the reference area, this should equal QI NI DA over the present area. So little q, lowercase q, is the rate of energy received through the boundaries in the present configuration per unit area, per unit surface area. And this one, capital Q or uppercase Q, QLNL, is the energy rate of energy received through the surface in the reference configuration. But their values are, total values are same. Okay, so to get a relationship between them, we notice that QI NI is DAI. And DAI, we have learned that if I transform everything to the reference configuration, then DAI equals J F inverse L I D A L. D A I equals F inverse J F inverse L I D A L. We derived this relation, I don't know, 2-3 weeks ago, actually more than at least a month ago. We derived a relationship between the area elements in the deformed state and area elements in the undeformed state. Okay, so if you buy that, so this is, now it's over the area in the reference configuration. So if we write it as J F inverse L I N L D A. All I'm doing is writing DAL as the unit vector times this magnitude. We are writing DAL as the unit vector times its magnitude. Now compare the two sides. Compare the left hand side with the right hand side. We are integrating over the same surface area. And this has to hold for every choice of the region R. Therefore, the integrands must be same. And that means QL equals J F inverse LI QI. So heat flux per unit area in the undeformed state. Heat flux per unit area in the undeformed state equals J, which is a Jacobian or determinant of F, then F inverse LI QI. So if you write in the direct notation, like no indices, then you will say Q equals J F inverse Q. There is no F inverse transpose in this case, whereas in the when we derived the relationship between Cauchy stress tensor and first Piola-Kirchhoff stress tensor, between nominal stress tensor and true stress tensor, we had F inverse transpose. But here there is no F inverse transpose because the summed index I is next to each other. So big Q equals J F inverse little q. So the we don't call it nominal heat flux, and we don't call big Q as nominal heat flux as we call first Piola-Kirchhoff stress tensor as nominal stress tensor. It's the nominal stress tensor you used in your mechanics of deforms class because you measured area in the undeformed state. Okay, so with this relation, we need to keep this relation in mind. So let's go back to our equation we wrote. And we see here we see here L and L. So this looks like a divergence theorem candidate. So we are going to use divergence theorem on this term, and we are going to use the divergence theorem on this term. So we can transform these area integrals into volume integrals. So we are going to use divergence theorem on wherever you see the, I forgot to put the circle on it. Wherever you see the area integrals, we are going to use the divergence theorem and convert that to volume integration. Also, this d over dt, now we are integrating over a fixed region. You can take it inside the integral sign. So what we get then is integral over r of rho 0 e dot plus vi dot dv. The reason we get the reason this 2 disappears is because when you differentiate with respect to time, you get vi dot vi plus vi vi dot. So these are like 2 terms. So that's why the 2 in the denominator disappears. This differential of x square is 2x x dot, and that's why that 2 will disappear. Okay, so on this term we don't do anything, so it's rho 0 bi vi dv. plus on this term, then we use the divergence theorem, and comma L means differentiation with respect to uppercase X. Comma L means differentiation with respect to uppercase X plus rho 0 R dV plus QL comma L. Does it make sense? We have used the divergence theorem. And now all the integrals are over the volume. So therefore the integrand on the left side must equal the integrand on the right side, because this equation has to hold for every choice of R. The key word is every choice of R. So you can make the region R small, or you can make the region R large. It's your choice. So if the word for every were not there, we could not conclude anything from it. So the key word is this equation has to hold for every choice of the region R. So those two words, for every, are the critical words. Okay, so if it's rho 0 E dot plus VI VI dot equal to rho 0 VI VI plus, let's use the differentiation by parts, let's use the differentiation by parts formula. So this, I have skipped one step. I have already used the differentiation by parts on this underlying term to get these two. Okay, any question about this? So at least two of you seem to be okay, Pierce and Jessica. Plus rho 0 R plus QL comma L. Okay, so I'm going to transfer this term to the right hand side and combine it with this and this. So the terms underlined with blue are going to be combined. Either underlined or check marked, they are going to be combined. So if we do that, what we get is rho 0 E dot equals VI is a common factor minus rho 0 VI dot plus rho 0 VI plus TIL comma L plus TIL VI comma L plus rho 0 R plus QL comma L. And I did make one mistake, because yesterday at night we had a minus sign here. Okay, so if that means I should put a minus sign here, and that will give me a minus sign here. It does not change anything except the thermal conductivity. Instead of coming out positive, it will be you can say it's negative. So nothing is changed. I mean, so I should have kept that minus sign to be consistent with what I had last night. sorry, I mean, I just realized that there is nothing changed except when you find the thermal conductivity, when you use the Fourier's law of heat conduction, and we'll find thermal conductivity. If I had kept plus sign here, I would have gotten a negative value of the thermal conductivity. And now I will get a positive value of the thermal conductivity. So, okay, now, what about this term? The one that is marked in the red color, or underlined in the red color. What is the sum of these three terms? Zero, because that's the balance of linear momentum. Okay, so that's the balance of linear momentum. So that vanishes. Therefore, we get rho zero E dot equal to T I L tilde delta V I over delta X L plus rho zero R minus Q L comma L. So this is the balance of internal energy. We started with the balance of total energy. What we have done is, by using this divergence theorem, we have eliminated the balance of kinetic energy. The working of working when you add I and G at the end of a word, it gives you rate rather than the quantity itself. So working is rate of work. So the working of external forces, which is body force and the surface tractions, it is used up to change the kinetic energy of the body and to deform the body. You need some energy to deform the body. Whether that energy is stored in the body or dissipated, whether it's recoverable or irrecoverable, depends upon the material of the body. If you use a dashpot in a car shock absorber to dissipate energy. So we use a dashpot in a shock absorber to dissipate energy, otherwise your car ride will be very bumpy. We use a spring in many places to store energy. But that is recoverable if it's an elastic spring. Whether it's linear elastic or non-linear elastic makes no difference. If it's a spring, the idea is that you can recover energy. So we denote elastic elements, which generally store energy, by springs, and we denote plastic bodies or viscoelastic bodies, viscous part, like Navier-Stokes fluid, viscous part, we denote by a dashpot that dissipates energy. And if it dissipates energy, the temperature of the body goes up. I mean, that energy that is dissipated, it's not gone anywhere. I mean, it is used up to heat the body. It is not recoverable, okay, in general.